ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Mind Tripping. Prepare to have your perceptions and your mind altered. Please welcome Christian and Catalina.
Oh, and then we're back. Yes.
All right. Hello.
Jamie. But he started clapping. I was clapping.
Most live entertainment acts are found on the nation's coasts. But the number one comedy mind-reading act in the nation, the Mind Tripping Show, is in the heart of the Midwest. This husband and wife performing duo, Christian Painter and Catalina Absalon, call Indianapolis, Indiana, their home.
I don't know that I consciously said, oh gosh, I want to be an entertainer. It just kept happening because I liked entertaining, but I never thought of myself as an entertainer, I think, until we kind of went professional, until we started actually doing it.
Okay, well, I had no plans to be an entertainer at all. I never saw myself on stage, never saw myself actually being in front of people, period.
Oh. Like Volt Budapest and the Lanz Hidhoz, Magyar Sagon Gellertet, Schenking Nam Volt Europapa.
Anybody speak Hungarian? Nope. Well, I think that pretty much proves what I say is true.
But we said, no, let's give it a shot. Let's go into performing. You can't possibly know everything that's involved when you get out, what this whole performance world is going to be like. We had no idea. In reality, we tried to prepare as much as possible, but the reality is just so different than what we thought that you just kind of have to learn as you go along.
We're both in the Army. We met at Fort Bragg, North Carolina,
mm-hmm.
jumping out of airplanes, actually. Mm-hmm. We're both paratroopers.
Yeah, actually, she showed up as my boss. I was an NCO. I just got out of Special Ops. I was working at Fort Bragg,
mm-hmm.
and then probably I'd been there maybe 3 or 4 months, and then you showed up
yep.
as my boss. I was not happy. Yeah,
awesome.
we didn't get along at first.
No, we did not get along.
Because we had totally different styles.
But, yes, we did.
It seemed to work out, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, it did work out. Except I had to salute my wife.
Actually, we had to make a decision because you only get stationed together if you're married. So we had to decide, are we going to get married or not? Because if not, we're not even going to be stationed together, and that was the end. And so we did. We decided to get married.
Oh, remember? This is what I got you. Remember when I was wishing for you? You came out of this. Remember that?
Yeah, that's my previous home.
Yeah, you were a little cramped in there, baby.
I was. Thank you for getting me out, baby.
And then we traveled around the world some more together, because once we got married, we were able to move all over or be stationed together. And then when we got out, went into magic. I think that's a pretty normal transition, isn't it? Yeah, Army and then entertainer. Yeah, sure. I'm sure it is. When I was in Germany, still in the military, I met a gentleman named Timo Mark. But we got together and we called ourselves Culture Shock. And it was the first time I worked with a partner. And when I came back to the States, I told my wife, I really like this energy of working with a partner. And I said, you should be in the show. So then she started getting trained up in the show, and that was working great.
Okay, but trained up means we're driving to a show, and he says, Kat, you're in the show.
But is this a credit card?
Yes.
Is it a MasterCard?
Yes.
Okay. Hold on. I'm seeing, is it the color blue?
Yes.
Okay.
All right. Perfect. Now, that's pretty good, huh? Yeah, let's get his credit card number.
Okay, we can do that.
Wait, some people are taking out pencils. So the premise of our show, or what we do in our show, is we wanted to create where Catalina is not the assistant, which is a normal thing in a kind of a magic show or in a husband-wife show, I think. Where I grew up, or when I grew up, you had shows like Dick Van Dyke on, you had shows like I Love Lucy,
mm-hmm.
George and Gracie, and then you would see that the husband and wife were a team that made you enjoy watching the show because they played off each other.
Gracie, I've got some glue here. You take this glue, put it around the plate, put the plate together, it'll be just like glue.
Yeah, I feel awful about that.
Well, just go right ahead.
That kind of show influenced me into the show that we do now.
When we actually started writing our own show, though, and you look at the sitcoms that were on at the time, the husband and wife was so negative.
It's my hot pocket. It has to be rotated. Excuse me.
What we do now, we didn't necessarily start out with all the mind-reading kind of stuff. We decided to try more of a character role where I would play this witch, and I would have this wig on, and I'd have this black cape, and
I would carry
this kind of scepter. His eyes glowed. It was a skull. It was very cool looking. I would, mm-hmm. you know, push the button, and red eyes would light up. Look at these evil scepters.
Yeah,
yes.
The evil scepters.
And so we would have to battle like this, then we kind of probably turned it like, it's hideous.
It was hideous.
We were so bad.
But it's a nightmare.
The eyes
Thanks
were the
for
best
bringing
part.
It back. Yeah. And whenever we have a bad idea, I just pull these back out to remind me.
Don't go down that way.
Don't push a bad idea on stage. It's bad. And I had many nightmares. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Let's put them away.
So, okay. What we realized, though, is that that type of performing is not for us. That's not our style. We're not dancers. We're not, you know, the beautiful movements like this that you have to have when you're doing that
right,
kind
right.
of performing.
Right, right. When you're doing the big illusions and that. And yeah, there's different styles of magic.
Mm-hmm.
And that was, and we, you know, we were exploring different styles as we were doing this, and that was one of the styles we wanted to explore. How many shows did we do before we thought we were good? Probably 500? Probably 500 before we thought, wow, we're good now.
Until we felt, okay, this is bulletproof.
What laundry detergent did you grab?
Era.
Now, I'm going to reach in here, and I'm going to pull out Era. Now, before I pull it out, though, there's no ambiguity on Era. Yeah, you wondered what was going to happen. It's Era. Do you know? No, because if it was tied, it would be 225. And like all,
is
yes. Do you have a barcode reader?
Yes. No, I'm just fluent.
We do.
That's back. Don't worry, it's too far back. Now, no, I'm just saying it drags the show. If we had time and you came up here and you beeped it, it would come up Era.
Where did he go?
Okay, so we played almost in every kind of venue. We played in cruise ships, mm-hmm. colleges, casinos, corporate, comedy clubs, nightclubs, every kind of venue. So traveling the world is great, and it's fun. However, there's a point where you start to realize, I'm never home. And you enjoy your own house. And when you're always on the road, you're in a different hotel every night or every few nights, it can get draining.
It was just sucking the energy out. We said, we've got to come up with something else.
I think our favorite, though, has been this, where we're performing in the hotel.
Oh, we love this.
Every Friday and Saturday night, Christian and Catalina perform their show at the Hilton in downtown Indianapolis. Their audience typically consists of about 50 people, teenagers and above. Sherry Fuller, Christian's sister, acts as show manager. Christian and Catalina's 90-minute show is, as they call it, a comedy with a psychological twist.
I want your brain to bubble and melt and slide down your spinal column. I want that. I mean, as you see, almost everything in our show is somehow we have to pull somebody up from the audience to do something.
Each audience is different, so you're always going to have something different in the show. It's never right. going to be the same show twice.
One, two, three, go! No! You nut! You were going to do it. It's a real life.
Christian and I decided a long time ago that we had our lanes. And that was the only way that we could really make this business and marriage work. So really, anything that has to do with the business side is really mine. Christian is he's very creative, and he can put together the stories. He's a great storyteller, so I think that's one of his biggest strengths.
They work all the time. People have asked me that before. They've said, well, do they have other jobs? Oh, no, this is a full-time job. They are constantly working.
This is how I get my workout right here. This is how I work out. And I sweat a lot. And, you know, as the eye candy of the show, that becomes a problem. I need some people to do the little dusting. Yeah. Do I look good? All right, good.
I don't think we would have been as successful today if it wasn't for the military. We see a lot of our friends that are artists. They're great at what they do, but they can't do the business side. That's not how their mind works. And unfortunately, if you want to be able to make money in any sort of artistic endeavor, you've got to have that organization, that structure, that discipline, as well as the creative side.
After 12 years of performing, Christian and Catalina have developed a show unlike any other on the entertainment scene.
They want everybody to have a good time at the show and feel good when they leave the show, about the show and about themselves.
So the question is, where would we like to go now? And it's funny, we've had a couple of friends ask us that recently. And right now, we're very happy with what we're doing. Mm-hmm. So we're not actually certain. We did look at one time opening a show in Las Vegas. You know, we're doing so well here and having fun and enjoying it. It becomes that battle. Why upset the cart?
Christian and Catalina, what you see is who they are. There's no fake facade about them. When you see them, when you talk to them, that's them. It's all real with them.
Ah! No. You weren't sure. Ah! Thank you.
Have a great day.
Thank you.